This initially started 4 years ago as the Womanchester Statue Project. It was going to be a statue of a woman of significance to Manchester. There are 17 statues of named people, 16 men and one woman, Queen Victoria. Surely we can do better than that, and that really is how it came about.
The names are all named after men, all the statues in Albert Square are men, and it's kind of like the women have been forgotten.
Project lead Andrew Simcock kicked off the fundraising for the project in 2015 with a sponsored bike ride from Land's End to John O'Groats. A long list of 20 inspirational Manchester women for consideration was announced, with each having made a significant contribution to Manchester.
That was then whittled down to a shortlist. We used SurveyMonkey to get the votes of thousands of people in Manchester and all over the world, actually, and Emmeline Pankhurst was the clear winner.
Emmeline Pankhurst was a Manchester-born political activist and leader of the suffragette movement who helped women win the right to vote. Artists were invited to submit their designs for this exciting project.
I put in my proposal and was shortlisted down to six, and then had to produce a bronze maquette of my ideas. I won the public vote and I was a unanimous choice of the panel, which was fantastic for me. And because it sort of combines my two passions for promoting women's rights and for figurative sculpture, it's a perfect gig for me.
The project has been actively supported by Emmeline's great-granddaughter, Helen Pankhurst, who is an international development women's rights activist and writer.
Just the way the whole project has come together, the way Andrew Simcock has initiated, the collaborative nature of it all, just every step along the way seems to me to have been symbolic of the importance of people coming together and doing this properly, that the method was really, really impressive.
After being selected, artist Hazel Reeves began the long process of creating her statue of Emmeline, called Rise Up Women.
I work in a very traditional method, which is as Rodin used to work. So first of all, we build an armature.
But the structure underneath has to be very, very strong and sturdy. So we built that out of steel. She then spent many months sculpting over the top of it.
So I've got my wonderful model, Sarah, and she comes in, and then I work on the unclosed figure.
So you unwrap the sculpture, Hazel will study it, see what adjustments she wants to make with a fresh eye, then I'll change into what I'll be wearing. Then we'll do some movements and work from there.
As the statue took shape in Hazel's studio near Brighton, Andrew Simcock organised a delegation from Manchester to see how the statue was progressing. Women from the Safe Spots charity and women councillors were invited to see the work in progress.
We're here today to go to Hazel's studio and have a good look at the work she's done so far, because we thought it was important to really, as a community project, for people to come and see and then tell people about it when they get back.
Andrew asked for volunteers to come forward to come on the trip, and I was really intrigued and I thought it'd be a great opportunity. Really, 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 really pleased to have been asked.
They'll come and have a look at her and be able to sort of ask any questions that they have. They'll be able to meet Sarah, the model, and we've just received her sort of costume, which she's been fitted for, so they'll be able to see her in costume as well.
What's really amazed me is, because I've been so involved in the whole project, having people who've not been involved come along and then just walk in and then go, wow, there's the work in progress. They've been really knocked over by it. So I'm just delighted to have been leading on this and being able to play a part in creating that.
Probably in sections.
Will it be hollow? Will it be hollow?
It will be hollow. So the bronze will be hollow and the wax that they make will be hollow.
A lot of the time things are done and you're not involved, so Andrew's made it perfectly clear it's a collaboration of engagement and consultation, which most things don't happen like that. So I do appreciate having the opportunity.
She's an amazing woman and I'm really proud to be doing this with her. She's definitely 100% feminist, her work, her background, everything. We discuss, we work together for hours at a time, and it makes working together really interesting.
That's about the thickness of the neck, roughly. And then I turn it over and that's scaled up.
We get to see the process at the moment, so that's really nice. And obviously with what Emily represents as well, it's just nice to know that obviously that's in Manchester and it's a big statement then, obviously, for women.
The fact that we are women councillors and that we are politicians is because of the work that Emmeline did to put us in that position where not just vote, but to be able to be in positions of power.
when the project first got set up, I was involved with Andrew from a lead member for Women Perspective in interviewing the potential sculptors, and it was a real fantastic opportunity for me to get involved in something that will make a difference for generations to come. So to be able to be here today and see that statue in progress is just absolutely fantastic, and it is an opportunity that I wouldn't have wanted to miss.
It's a real privilege to sculpt someone that is a hero, which is a hero of mine, a hero of Manchester, I mean, a hero of women's rights activists across the world. So with that comes a responsibility. It's got to be good, it's got to be powerful, it's got to have an impact. I've chosen for Emmeline to be in around 1908, 1909, and that was a point which was absolutely critical for the suffragette movement. They were absolutely incensed by the repeated political betrayal, and it was like, enough is enough, time for deeds, not words. And so that sort of changed their activism, and getting out onto those streets was an important part of that. And I was so keen that she should be dynamic, up on a chair, addressing the crowds, urging women to rise up, demand their right to vote. And I want people to be able to hear her above the crowds.
Whilst Hazel continued to refine the clay, another part of the process was taking shape too, a stone meeting circle. Preparations for the meeting circle and statue arriving included an inspection by Manchester City Council to find out what lay beneath the paving stones, and the installation of a reinforced concrete base by Roskell.
The stone circle is made out of white Portland stone. I went down to Dorset to the quarry where the stones come from, and Jeremy Tilley, the stonemason's based in Brighton, he came up on Monday of this week with his three colleagues. They've been busily putting the stone circle in, generating great excitement from passers-by, particularly with Ollie, the guy that's been carving the final letters, Deeds Not Words, Rise Up Women.
The meeting circle was unveiled to an excited crowd on the 15th of July 2018, on what would have been Emmeline's 160th birthday.
Life, strife, these two are one. Naught can ye win but by faith and daring. On, on, that ye have done, but for the work of today preparing.
For me personally, after 4.5 years of working on this project, I've got to say that I'm incredibly proud that we've got this pivotal moment, the unveiling of the meeting circle, which is going to take place shortly.
It's so important that this memorial is happening here in Manchester, the birthplace of Emmeline, her home, most importantly as well, the place where the WSPU, the suffragette movement, was formed.
I'm just so positive about the whole project. It's really difficult to explain to what extent. It's about what she represented to so many women at the time, this courage, the belief in themselves, the idea that women could be equal, all of that, and those messages still so relevant today.
So this is a space for our current day Emmelines. The idea is it'll be for them to come, to meet, to speak, to celebrate, to protest, and to re-energise.
It's encouraging more women to understand about what it was like to be a woman 100 years ago, and that you didn't have a vote and you didn't have a voice. And so it's really, really important that young women of today understand what women of the past went through just to get a vote.
I was delighted to be invited to work with Hazel designing lettering, and I wanted to use a typeface that was contemporary, really, with the period. And so this typeface that I've used is News Gothic, which was 1908. Everything's come to life and it's wonderful. I'm thrilled with the results.
And when you actually see it and the beautiful Portland stone, and you think, this is going to be where people are going to sit and enjoy Manchester, and you're going to have this wonderful statue.
And it seems to me like the public have really got hold of it and really embraced the idea of the statue. And I absolutely love what Hazel has done, and the idea of the circle and being a meeting place. And then in this generation of selfies and social media, you know, you could be having your photograph taken with Emmeline. It's just brilliant.
Happy birthday, dear Emmeline. Happy birthday to you.
Excellent.
With the meeting circle now in place, the reality of the full-sized Emmeline was getting a step closer. Once Hazel was happy that the clay work was complete, it was time for the statue to move to the next stage on its way to being turned into bronze.
I've been working with Bronze Age Sculpture Casting Foundry for a few years now, and they've done all my big pieces, and I built up a really good relationship with them. They've got a very skilled team here. Once the clay had been completed, then the foundry came to my studio.
Another team from the foundry went and made the mould of the piece, brought it back here. I made the wax copy, did all the wax work, and then Hazel came in, and then we worked on it together for 2 weeks. And then we broke it down and put it into for the next process, which is ceramic shell.
And becomes covered in this sort of ceramic shell, and that's encased inside and outside. And the void that was left by the wax that's been heated out, that void will be filled by the molten bronze.
They're going to pour the upper section, the top torso and head of the Emmeline Pankhurst piece.
Because Emmeline is so large, she can't be poured in one piece. She has to be poured in sections, and there are going to be two big sections. So today, we're getting from the top of the hat down to the bottom of the jacket.
So we're going to see some very hot metal being poured very precisely into these ceramic shells.
We get the ingots, they look like blocks of gold, and it takes about 3.5 hours to melt the bronze.
It has to get up to about 1200 degrees centigrade, so you can imagine it looks amazing, and it's just like being back in the olden days. You imagine part of the Industrial Revolution. The bronze process is quite magical, and it is the alchemy of turning something that I spent so long on in clay that suddenly, well, it just takes a little effort, but it turns from clay into bronze. Yes, there's processes in between, but it's like quite magical, that transformation that happens.
When you work on a public piece, especially, you know, as famous as Emmeline was, it's a sense of pride. And when you see the finished piece, knowing you had a little part in the making of it, it's good.
Once the pour's completed, then the metalwork starts. First of all, they take off the ceramic shell by blasting that, and then they'll weld her together in sections. Then she'll be sandblasted, and then we'll go into the patination process, which is basically the colouring process using heat and chemicals.
Once the bronze Emmeline was complete, it was time to transport her to her final home in St Peter's Square, Manchester. The statue was planned to be oriented towards the site of the former Free Trade Hall, significant in the history of the suffragettes.
Emmeline came up last night, and so this morning they've been craning her in position.
In conjunction with the artist, we decided exactly where the sculpture was going to go and which way it's going to face. We marked out the fixing holes and then drilled and fixed the sculpture to the ground with resin.
We work with Hazel on a number of projects, Cracker Packers and Sir Nigel Grizzly down at King's Cross. And obviously we're very happy to install this sculpture for her. I particularly like working with Hazel because her sculptures depict historical figures, and as such it's easier for a lot of people to relate to them.
Now Emmeline's here, I'm really sort of starting to feel a little bit excited about tomorrow.
The unveiling of Hazel's statue, Rise Up Women, was held on the 14th of December 2018. Which was the 100th anniversary of the first women being able to vote in the UK in a general election. The selection of Emmeline Pankhurst as the subject and Hazel Reeves as the artist was a public choice, and the people of Manchester were all invited to participate in celebrating the unveiling. With around 5,000 people expected at the event in St Peter's Square, the infrastructure was put in place for such a big gathering. Whilst Hazel and the team made sure that the statue was looking its best and ready to be unveiled, across the city, people were getting ready to march.
Equality!
When do we want it?
Now!
Thousands of people, including 1,000 children from 31 schools, gathered at two symbolic meeting spots, the People's History Museum and the Pankhurst Centre, to march to St Peter's Square and welcome Emmeline.
We took 100 girls to Denmark Road on a couple of coaches this morning with placards and sashes, and we all collected together and then marched down Oxford Road with hundreds and hundreds of other schools and women's groups in the city.
We were like saying deeds not words and shouting what do we want, equality, and when do we want it now, that kind of thing.
The massive crowd sang, chanted and marched their way to St Peter's Square, where they were welcomed by the uplifting voices of the Manchester Community Choir.
Nana was a suffragette, spent the night in jail, singing vaults for women.
One of the most remarkable moments in this campaign was to hear from an 11-year-old girl from Withenshaw addressing the City Planning Committee to argue the case for this statue. And she's here today.
As a young person, the statue means a lot to me and my generation. It's a symbol of a woman who did good for the women of Manchester, it's a symbol of equality, and it's a symbol of Manchester being a modern and forward-looking city.
For quite a while now, this project has become, for me, a full-time, unpaid job. And I can now, as chair of this Emmeline Pankhurst statue campaign, officially declare myself redundant. Thank you.
100 years ago, exactly, right across this country, for the first time, millions of women were voting. It happened because of the commitments of millions, because of the sacrifices of thousands, because of the leadership of a few, and amongst those few, one woman, Emmeline Pankhurst.
I'm really proud of Manchester's role in the history of women's suffrage. And though it's taken 100 years, I cannot think of a better choice than to honour Emmeline Pankhurst in this way.
For me, this statue represents so many hard-fought-for rights that we now have, but also acts as a reminder that we are not yet there.
Together, we are honouring the legacy of Emmeline and the suffragists, and who did so much for us we should never forget. And I'd like to welcome all of the women here today to come and help me unveil this beautiful statue. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Emmeline, I'm so sorry. Your statue has been a long, long time coming. Exactly 100 years since you proudly first placed your ballot paper into that box. It's been a huge privilege, it really has, and a real labour of love. And I dedicate this statue to your friends, the modern day Emmelines, and the future generations of Emmelines. So a few essential thank yous. The two women that were with me throughout the months, and I couldn't have done it without them. So we have Sarah Jenkins, who is my model for Emmeline, and my sister Sandra, the artist, who was always ever ready with practical and artistic support.
If we win this hardest of fights, to be sure, the future will be made easier.
The statue is absolutely beautiful. I mean, I just love the way that she is on a chair, that she has this demand for change, arm raised out there. I think it's fabulous. I love it.
I'm crying tears of joy because it's absolutely been brilliant. It was key that a woman was a sculptor. Hazel has done a fantastic job, but she is also an active and vocal person about her craft and about the subject matter. So it was brilliant.
It's beautiful. We all got a little bit emotional watching it being unveiled. It's, you know, it's so powerful.
People have come out on the lunch breaks, and there's been schools and loads of different people getting excited wearing sashes and suffrage colours of purple, green and white. So yeah, it's been really good.
Well, the school has been involved since the statue was first announced. Emmeline's daughters actually went to Manchester High School for Girls, and we're very proud to have been involved in the march today. We've also had some involvement with workshops, creating artwork for today, and we've also done a number of other things to celebrate the Pankhurst legacy.
Oh, absolutely fabulous. The atmosphere, the buzz around, and then just the build-up to the unveiling of the statue, which is fantastic. And to bring the younger generations to be part of such a memorable occasion that will be lasting in Manchester for a long time is very significant for us.
Today has been really good. I really liked going on the march.
For young girls today and women today, it's just to know that they've got this history behind them and they can do whatever they want to do, because these women have done it in the past. They need to be reminded of who these great women are you know, what they've achieved, and they can, if they can do that, I can do something now.
I think it's been really good because it was kind of like a momentous occasion because we saw a statue unveiling, which not many people will get a chance to see. So I'm really pleased and it was really fun.
We just walked up with the young people up to here to see the speeches and hear some of the music and see the statue unveiling.
We're not going to sit in silence.
It's been incredibly inspirational, quite emotional. It's just a nice atmosphere. I think it just adds to that whole spirit of Manchester and what Manchester's about. And Manchester really is about radical change and the suffragette movement and everything that it represents for this city.
Today has been really exciting and I've loved it because I got to march through town and got to see the second ever woman statue being put up in Manchester.
I'm very pleased there's so many schools that they brought the children. You know, I think that's lovely, you know.
People will come along and have their photograph taken and they'll remember what she did, but also inspire people into acting for change and just doing what they need to. Men and women, young girls, young boys, tourists, Mancunians, everybody. It's fabulous.
I think it represents Emmeline Pankhurst really well.
She's a progressive, she's a rebel, she fights for what she needs and wants and for other people. It's my birthday today and what a wonderful thing to have on my birthday.
Oh, amazing. It's just been absolutely fantastic from start to finish. The atmosphere, the marches, the chants, it's been incredible.
Emmeline Pankhurst really deserved this statue, and if it wasn't for Emmeline, we wouldn't have the vote. Nothing could have been better because it was the best day of my life.
It's been wonderful, you know, the thousands of people coming to celebrate, the chanting, the marching, the sense of energy, of positivism, of wanting to honour a single person, but also wanting to honour all of those, the suffragettes, the suffragists who fought to get us this far. And then pivotally for me, the bit that really gets to my heart is the sense of so many of them knowing that it's a journey and that we're not there yet. We're not at our destination. We're not at the destination of equality and we've still got so much to do. Hence the importance of having young people asking questions here, chanting equality. When do we want it? Now. Really powerful.